Okay, here we're trying to do another moles to grams problem. And let's go with our strategy again. Let's identify first what we're given and then what we need to find. So I'm given moles of water. That's what I'm given. And I want to find grams. That's what I want. So once I know what I'm looking for, I can go ahead and set the problem up to cancel out the units and end up with, in this case, grams. So let's see, I got 10.31 moles of H2O, and I need to multiply it by something that's going to cancel out the moles. So I know that I'm going to need moles of H2O on the bottom and grams on the top. And what's nice about that is then I can end up with the grams I'm looking for here in my final answer. So grams per mole is just the GFM. In the last problem, we calculated the GFM of H2O using our periodic table to be 18.02 grams per mole. So we have 18.02 grams in one mole. Lots of people like to just extend this over here, but really we're going to multiply 10.31 moles of water times this conversion factor here. And when we do that, you'll see that the moles cancel out and we're actually left with the grams that we were looking for. So I'm going to take 10.31 times, oh, my calculator's not on. There we go. 10.31 times 18.02. And we would divide that by 1. It wouldn't change anything. So we end up with 185.786. But let's round that 8 up to 79. And there we have the answer. So what we've done is we've identified what we've given, what we want. We set up the problem to cancel these out, did our math, and now we need to see if this 185 number makes sense. Well, if one mole is about 20 grams and I have 10 times 20 is 200, so I should be somewhere near 200. And I think that's close enough that we can be pretty confident that our answer makes sense, and we went from moles to grams.